Well, hey there, everybody. Abbi from Abbi Kirsten Collections here. We're going to be talking about the new combine tools in Cricut Design Space. Okay, so here on my screen, I'm just going to show you very practical examples of what each of these new tools does. The layers panel sort of got a refreshed look over here, but essentially all of the same tools are there. We have our layers, we have our color sync, and then if we select an object, we also have the duplication icon still, as well as the delete icon. So those are all still present. They just got a little bit of a refreshed look. And then down here at the bottom of the layers panel, let me select two items, you're gonna see this new tool that says combine. And there's this little arrow next to it. And if you click on it, it's gonna reveal all of the new tools that they added here to the Design Space layers panel. So this is where the Weld tool used to hang out. And the Weld tool is still there, so you can still use it just as you always have. But instead of having the Weld tool to where once you've done the weld and you've closed a project out and it's a permanent thing, they've also added a Unite tool, which allows you to do what Weld does, but you can undo it at any time. So that's really great. They also have added Subtract, Intersect, and Exclude. Everything down here, Unite, Subtract, Intersect, and Exclude, can all be undone at any point in time, even if you've closed the project out. So that's really great to be able to customize things and design more here in Cricut Design Space directly. So let's cover an example of each one of these tools and then how you would undo them, and then how you can also merge things in your layers panel so that you can combine and keep a neat and tidy layers panel, okay? All right, so to show you a practical example, I'm just gonna use a heart from my shapes panel. It's a free image. I'm going to change it here. I'm going to duplicate using my duplicate icon at the layers panel there, or you can hold Control or Command D on your keyboard. To have contrast, let's change the color. And I'm just going to overlap these two hearts slightly to show you an example. So this is our original. I'm just going to have a duplicate of the original so you can always see what it looks like initially there. Okay. And let's go down to that combine function and click it there. So let's click on Weld because that's what's still present and what was there before this. So let's weld. If we weld, that's going to eliminate any overlapping cut lines. Now, when we look in our layers panel here, it says weld result. Notice that there is no way to unweld. We are not able to click on this and then click down here and click unweld. That still does not exist. But if we click the undo button, and go back to our original state, we can now click and drag over both of those. And let's try the Unite option. Unite performs pretty much exactly the same as Weld, except that you can undo it. So that's the wonderful function of Unite. I suspect most people will go to using Unite, and I would predict that maybe Cricut would eventually even go away with the Weld tool because Unite is just very similar, but it allows you to undo and redo things. So that also eliminated our overlapping cut line there as well. Okay, so there's a function of the Unite. Now look over here in the layers panel. We see the word Unite present for these two hearts that are sitting underneath it. That's telling us that these two hearts are under this Unite function here. But what that also means is we can undo this function. So when we click on those hearts, we can still hit the combine tool, and now we see undo Unite is now present. So we can undo that and go back to our original hearts. Now it did change the color on us here, so we would have to change that back here in the layers panel. I'm sorry, in the next to the operations tool right there, the little color swatch, we would have to change that color back. But the two hearts are now separate again. So that's how we would unite and then undo unite at the same time. Let's select both these again, and let's try the subtract tool. So when we click on the subtract tool, it's going to cut out the overlapping shape. So whatever shape is on top, that was our navy heart. The navy heart was on top of the pink heart. So whatever shape is sitting on top is going to be sliced out of the bottom shape, okay? So we can also undo this. So we would click on our result. We see over here in our layers panel that we have a subtract result. Then we have the original, which is hidden, the navy heart that was on top. It's now hidden because it's no longer there. And then we have also the other heart that was sitting underneath that's now created this subtract result. So If we want, we can click combine again, and we can do undo subtract. Again, it changes that navy color to a pink. You'd have to change the swatch over here, but it undoes the result. And so you can now again select these and move them freely from each other and go back to its original state. So it's great if you need to practice doing things and you don't want to get stuck and not be able to go back a step, even if you've closed a project out. So it's really functional tools. These are tools that are a lot closer to working with graphic software, so they're definitely advancing this. Let's also look at intersect. So if we click on intersect, that's going to produce whatever result is the overlap. So just the space that these two hearts are overlapping is going to be the intersection point, and that's the shape you're going to be left with. So we have this kind of awkward like piece of a heart here left because that's the part that was intersecting and overlapping. It's just that cutout. Again, in the layers panel here, we see that we have that intersect and we have the two original hearts that were present underneath it, which means we can go back to that combine and we can undo the intersection as well. Change this color back. And let's try the other one as well. I'm gonna select both of those by clicking and dragging, and then let's try the Exclude tool. And these helpful little sort of infographics here next to each of these kind of gives you an idea of what it does. But with intersect, we had that overlapping piece cut out. Now it's gonna do the exact opposite. It's going to slice out the overlapping area and exclude that piece from this design, this overlapping design. Again, in the layers panel, we have our result and then our layers underneath from which that result was produced. If we go back up here or down here to the combine, we can hit undo. Now let's also take a look at the merge option, okay? Because there is a new function when we select these results here, select these two hearts. Let's go with the subtract option, okay? So that's gonna cut out that overlapping area. And in our layers panel, we see the subtract result and then we see what it was created from underneath it. If we go down to the combine tool now and we can click on this option here that says merge layers. And what merge layers is gonna do is it's going to get rid of these additional sublayers you're seeing here. So once you merge layers, that essentially makes it more permanent on your canvas. So if you're not sure if you want this to be the end result, then don't merge your layers yet, just leave it alone. And if you are sure and you wanna clean up your layers panel and eliminate some of these extra drop-down areas, then you can just click merge. And now we have our merged result here. Notice when we have our merged result with this item clicked, that combine function is no longer clickable, which means we can't go and undo the subtract now that we've merged our layers, okay? So don't use merge unless you're sure that you're happy with the final result of whatever combine tool that you have used here. Now, I also wanna show you here that if we add a third heart, I just duplicated this. If we add a third heart and we click and drag, we can also use these tools with more than two items selected, which is really great because a lot of this function here was drawn from the slice tool functionality. It's just honing in on very specific results now. But we can use this with more than two objects, whereas with the slice tool, you always had to use only two objects at a time. So let's give this a try with just the three objects selected. Let's try the intersect and just see what happens. All right, so this is the result when we do intersect. So how did it actually get that result? Let me undo this real quick. So this little space here where all three of these hearts are overlapping and they're all touching in that one area, that would be our intersection result. Now, if we try a different one, let's try exclude. Now we have all of these cutouts from any place that they were overlapping. And the same thing goes for the other tools. We could do subtract, which is gonna result in subtracting both of the top layers from the base layer. So it will result in subtracting both of those at the same time. So if you wanna multitask or get a lot of things subtracted at once, then you can do that with using more than one object selected and using that subtract tool. So let me undo that again. And then let's try the unite and the weld are gonna behave very similarly. Again, it's just gonna weld that together. It's gonna unite it. If you want it to be merged, that's when we would go down here and we would click merge layers. And now we have our merged result. Once we've merged it, again, if you close this out, then you will not be able to go back and undo that. So make sure you're happy with your results before you use the merge function. I also want to show you the new function in the layers panel here where you can name things and customize them more. So for this subtract result, it's going to name it as a subtract result, but maybe we don't want it to be named that. Maybe we want it to be named heart 2, for example. We can double click with our mouse and we can now change that by typing in whatever name we want to give that layer. If we click on any one of these sublayers when we have not yet merged, so this is before merging, you'll be able to see sort of a guide of where those original layers were before we used one of the combined tools. So that's kind of helpful if you're needing to make adjustments and go back and forth. So you can also name these sublayers. So at any time I can click into any of the sublayers and I can also give them a specific name. So that is really great. So let's say I'm ready to, I've named everything. Let me try this and change it back to heart 2. And let's say I'm happy with this result. It produced what I needed to, and now I want to clean up my layers panel. I'm going to go down to that combine tool and I'm going to merge my layers. And now we have our merged result. I don't recommend necessarily naming this until after you've decided if you want to merge, because then you're going to have to rename it. So we would click on this and then we could name it to be heart 2. But I wanted to show you the practical function of it. No matter if you've merged or not, you can rename any of these layers now. All right, so that is essentially what these new tools do. Lots of options and opportunities to create new shapes here in Design Space and to really customize our designs. So what questions do you have for me about these new tools? Make sure you let me know in the comments below. I'll be happy to help you.